Hi everyone, my name is Marissa and I have a bachelor's degree in mathematics with a minor in statistics. In today's lesson, I will discuss the properties of a normal distribution, the importance of z-scores, and the definition of the empirical rule. What do we notice when we think about the heights of everyone we know? We probably notice that some people are very short or tall, but most people fall somewhere in the middle. We call variables like this normally distributed or bell-shaped. Aside from height, examples of other variables that follow the normal distribution are IQ, SAT scores, and birth weights. Two key values that make up the standard normal distribution are the mean and standard deviation. If a variable is normally distributed, it will have a mean, mu, of 0, and a standard deviation, sigma, of 1. Values to the right of the mean are positive, and values to the left of the mean are negative. The mean is in the center of the bell curve. It is computed by simply adding all our values and then dividing by the number of numbers. For example, if we have the numbers 5, 3, and 7, we would compute the mean by adding 5, 3, and 7, and then dividing them by 3. This gives us the mean of 5. While the concept and computation of the mean are rather simple, the standard deviation is a bit more complex. The standard deviation measures the amount of variability in a data set, or how much the data varies from the average. There are two ways to find the standard deviation. One way is used when we have all data points from a population, and the other is used when we only have a sample of data points from a population. Population standard deviation is denoted by the Greek letter sigma, and the standard deviation, for a sample, is denoted with a lowercase s. In order to compute the population standard deviation, we must first compute the mean. Next, we subtract the mean from each data point, square the difference, and then add them together. After that, we must divide by our sample size, denoted by the letter n. Lastly, we take the square root of our result. Using the same numbers we used for the mean, we obtain a population standard deviation of 1.63. Calculating the sample standard deviation is identical. We just divide by n minus 1 rather than n. The n for population standard deviation is also capitalized, and the n for sample standard deviation is not. Please note that when using the normal distribution, sigma is always used for standard deviation. We previously mentioned that a variable that is normally distributed will have a mean of 0 and a standard deviation of 1. However, it should be noted that 0 and 1 are standardized values for the mean and standard deviation. Using the mean and standard deviation, we can determine how much a particular data point deviates from the mean by computing the number of standard deviations it is away from the mean. This is known as a z-score. A z-score is computed by subtracting our observed value, the x in our formula, from the mean and dividing it by the standard deviation. The farther a z-score is from 0, the less common the value is. Once we know the z-score of a data point, we can use the empirical rule to show us approximately what percentage of our data lies within 1, 2, and 3 standard deviations. Also known as the 68, 95, 99.7 rule, the empirical rule states that roughly 68% of all data points lie within 1 standard deviation to the left or the right of the mean. 95 lie within 2, and 99.7 lie within 3. Because the formulas for population and sample standard deviation are so similar, they can be very easy to mix up. In order to avoid this mistake, carefully read the problem to understand whether or not the entire population is being used. Another mistake to avoid is subtracting the x value from the mean. Take time to memorize the formula for computing a z-score. It is a simple formula, and memorizing it can help in avoiding this mistake. Lastly, one must understand that the 68, 95, and 99.7 values of the empirical rule cover values both to the left and to the right of the mean. A good way to avoid this mistake is to also think of the empirical rule as having 34% of values being 1 standard deviation to the left of the mean and 34% 1 standard deviation to the right of the mean, rather than just thinking 68% covers both sides. The same logic can be applied to the 95 and 99.7 part of the rule as well. Now that we have learned about the normal distribution, z-scores, and the empirical rule, let's put them all together by doing a practice problem. A class containing 5 students scored the following on a statistics test: 45, 65, 75, 85, and 90. Using the empirical rule, between what two scores did 95% of the class receive? Using the data we have and the formulas we learned today for mean and population standard deviation, we calculate our mean and population standard deviation to be 72 and 16, respectively. Note that we used the formula for population standard deviation because the problem specified the data set was taken from the entire class, which is our population. Now that we know our mean and standard deviation, we can find that two standard deviations to the left of the mean is 72 minus 16 times 2, which is 40. And to the right of the mean is 72 plus 16 times 2, which is 104. Thus, we can conclude that 95% of the students scored between 40 and 104. I guess someone got a lot of bonus points. Great job, everyone. Today we learned about the properties of the normal distribution. We also learned about the importance of z-scores. Lastly, we learned about the definition of the empirical rule and how to apply it to formulas. Thanks for watching, and please check out other videos about statistics applications and lessons here on Chegg. Have a fantastic day, and I'll see you next time.